Hello everyone, here we are again with another 3v3. We have eXecutors against NS, and with me for streaming we have Pablo, Idri,
hello,
Cauldron,
hello,
Jack.
What's up?
And I think that's everyone. But big group of us today.
Kane as well.
Oh, Kane as well, sorry, I forgot you arrived.
Hello.
So what are we thinking,
yeah,
gentlemen?
Yeah.
I need to see the lineup first.
Tough one, actually. Tough one. Normally it's NS, but I think Executives have really
I mean,
been
we see Blue's lineup, but I want to see what Red's going to pull on.
I think Executors could do something here.
I think NS are the favourites, but I think Executors may actually win it.
Well, they've got good players. Cooper, Iste. I think they're the first two I'd have on the team.
I also have known Tamo for so many
years. I wouldn't
sell
Brett Actual either.
No, absolutely not.
Oh, but so that's the lineup. Okay,
I
so
think
Brett Tech.
Yeah.
I'm going to go with
Brett Tech.
I'm going to go with Blue for this, if that's the lineups.
Yeah, I mean, they are favorites. Not going to...
I mean, I think...
And undersell it.
What do we reckon for maximum frag count? I'm gonna go with 41. The blue team.
So if you're over, you lose, or like, how are we playing? Price is
just
right.
The close,
like, what is
just
it?
The closest.
41.
For 30.
I think
I'm gonna go with.
Sure.
That's too generous.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go with.
I agree.
33.
Ooh, that's what I said last time. I'm gonna go.
Ooh, did you?
I think
go...
it's gonna be a feisty match. I'm going high.
I'm going 29.
We got 33, 29, 35. And did you want to recalculate your
penis
decision?
I'm looking for. What do you think, Pablo?
Well, what?
Oh, you're not on the server, are you?
Oh, you haven't joined yet.
No, I never joined. Who is
so
playing?
It's EXecutors against.
Don't tell him. Make him fucking join so he can.
Against
learn
No Surrender.
And why is the stream, huh?
It's Brattak, Uber, Iste against Tomo, Sai, and MNU.
Always with my friend Manu. Manu is going to be the MVP.
Mokey dokey.
Aww.
Aww.
That's cute.
MNU's a fair shout for MVP, but we'll see.
I mean, when Manu actually decides to turn on, he can really turn on, but...
He's definitely the one to watch on NS, for sure.
Like, he's not somebody that you just want to pass by. Like you definitely have to keep track of him.
And, I don't know. Fly's dangerous.
What's that?
I said Sai's dangerous.
Oh, yeah, Sai?
Yeah, whereas I think Tomo will play it safe.
I think Tomo's going to be the general glue of the blue team that kind of keeps it all, teamwork, everything together. I think Manu or Sai, one of them will end up being the aggro.
This is such a bad room to fight in, by the way, with the four pillars and the platform. It's so tight and messy.
I love this room, are you kidding me? I prefer being like, oh wow, never mind.
What?
I was gonna say I prefer being tight.
Oh yeah. But...
There we go.
Yeah.
Oh god.
I got you all to laugh. It's okay. That's all that matters.
Oh, nice jump by Manu.
The children of the players from the JK community might watch this Twitch channel.
Oh, fantastic jump by Manu.
What did you say, Pablo?
Not like I know I don't mind this map, but it's just not interesting.
What?
The map. I would have preferred a better map.
So
all these base maps are uninspired choices.
This I don't know why this particular map I have very bad FPS on. I don't know why. This one I think I have bad FPS on, and
I
think
your computer.
Everything else is fine.
Good job by Sai. You must have an old computer.
I mean, I got it during like COVID time, but it's a laptop. It's not like some powerhouse, like huge operating system. It's just a laptop.
You know what would improve this map? If it glowed with the color of the winning team.
It's
always blue by default.
And it's shaded.
Who has
if
lead?
If you switch to red, if red were in the lead, that'd be really fun.
Oh, that would be cool.
That would be so sick, actually.
And then, like, it would be really intense if the teams were going back and forth.
Where all the colors are based on the score of the teams, basically.
Yeah, because it's a very blue map by default, and I don't like it.
Yeah, and then and it could easily be a totally red map, too, with that same shading. That's sick. Nice, nice.
A good idea.
Does somebody know anyone who knows how to do that?
And they technically
Dago probably knows how to do it.
They'd technically have the advantage then because it'd be hard to see their sabers.
Yeah, well I always feel that like blue team have like suited.
Well yeah, same thing with blue though.
Yeah, exactly. Whoever's winning has a small advantage.
I mean I'm not gonna lie, like when I've been in matches, I change like my certain skin or this or that to match the game, like to match the map, so it's harder for my opponents.
This is a very strong opening by NS, by the way.
Very, very stable. They've caused executors problems.
I did not think it
was
going to
start. Oh, that was close.
So close.
Oh,
he fell from the
edge. For worse, though, for
he fell in the pit.
We all grabbed out.
Ooh, I'm not gonna lie. Sai lately has been getting really good.
There's MNU with 4-0, coming around killing everyone.
Oh my god, he's 4-0.
Brassac almost got him.
Oh,
Brassac gets
right. He's 2-2, so obviously he's doing by far the best of that team. I think things change if executors can just chill out and get a bit of stability.
They need room. They're a jumpy team.
The one thing, Manu thrives on chaos. He loves psycho chaos stuff. It's when he's the best.
Because he's a very, very good player at picking players out with his jumps. Like
exactly,
and just long jumps that you can't see coming. He's very good at that.
Yeah.
His sticker caught the 1v1 on the side, which was a bad move.
Whose map pick was this?
I'm not sure.
I'm sorry?
Whose map pick? Yeah, I'm not sure who challenged who.
Executors need a big, big map with lots of space so they can jump and do their teamwork.
Yeah.
They don't do well in tiny spaces.
I love tiny spaces. It's where I thrive.
Don't. It's too easy.
Oof.
I managed to keep quiet.
Wait, what?
Barely.
You like tiny spaces, like
the
where you thrive.
Here at time.
Oh my god, I hate you. Oh my god.
We were all thinking it.
Okay, you guys said it. I didn't even like, fuck you both. Oh, like, whatever. Whatever.
It's just the theme now. All my mind's in the gutter.
Guys, I'm busy. Let me watch my match.
I think they do
my
well
program.
On
That was a nice kill by Brassac on Tomo.
He's doing well overall. I think they do well on the map.
Like a steepy upcut.
That we pick usually. The I can't think of his name. The one that Reap made.
What did
say? Abafar?
Yeah, Abafar, that's it, yeah.
I love Abafar, honestly.
Great.
Also known as Pepe's Workshop.
Yeah.
Pepe's
it's such
workshop.
An interesting game, I love it.
Doesn't have like the same vibe as Abafar.
It's such a Star Wars name, isn't it? Pepe. Yeah.
It's my favorite map in the game at the moment, though. So good.
Yeah, it's good.
Ishte had two knights to kill. He killed Sai and Tomo, and then he died by Sai.
Not bad.
The Qbert's the one that seems to be struggling the most so far. I mean, it's a difficult game. I'm not being critical.
Well, he's done some damage as well. It's
they need to...
Frags.
I feel like we said, Manu likes chaos, and that's where he thrives, and I feel like they need to... Because he also creates it with the type of shit that he pulls off.
He's very mobile, like he's constantly jumping around the team.
And they need to kind of put him in his, like, control him a little bit more so he doesn't create as much chaos, so he doesn't, like, keep bragging. Well,
see, the trouble is, he's protected by both Tomo and Sai really well.
Sai creates
so much space for him. Like, for singlers, he's a bit different if the other team's got, like, a really... Tanky Staffer.
Oh. Back in a sec.
The difference is not that... It's not that big of a difference, though. Gap. 7 frags is not that much.
But as a percentage, though, I think they're... Yeah, I think they're going to be happy with this.
Yeah. But, you know, ultimately, in the end... It's about who has more frags.
9 frag difference, 8 frag difference. It's these who could jump there, but
if this was Elo, I would be very concerned.
Yeah, absolutely.
For me, like this is the type of like purport, like probably like a ratio. This is the type of ratio that really is like, okay, you really have to step it up next round, or you're just gonna lose.
Yeah.
But, like, you can do it, but you have to actually make sure you do it, you know? Like. And actually.
PK, that's unfortunate. Bratak struggled the last few minutes. Now back down to 5-10, which is unfortunate. He was doing well before.
I don't know. There's something that tells me, though, that the next round they might just blow up, though. I feel like... I don't know, we'll see.
It's hard to tell. Need to regroup, anyway.
I would have kept Tina in there, because I think he has the most game experience.
Who?
Cena.
All right, yeah. He has a lot of experience. Good hit there by Tomo and Bratak.
Manny was like on. Fire. Like he's not moving at all. He's just going on to the next and the next and the next and the next. Oh.
But No Surrender will definitely be happy with that round.
Nice.
Very solid, very comfortable.
Yep.
Good round, yeah.
They never lost control of the rounds from start to finish.
I can't believe Man United drew with fucking FC 20. I know. What's that? How does that happen? Everyone was saying we were going to win at least like 5-0 or something.
Oh, and I'm back.
I said 33.
Goes 41 frag dream.
33. Ooh, Sky Pairs 36. I said 36.
You said yes. Fuck.
Yeah.
But there we go. That could be it.
But, oh my god. No, I thought you said 35.
No, I said 30. Don't you fucking lie. And I win. Give me my money. I'm out of here.
Dude, if I could, like, totally, like, high-five you in the air right now, I totally would.
Thank you. I'd appreciate that.
You totally had nice. I mean...
That was a tough fight for eXecutors, but they put up a good show.
That was good. That was really good, yeah.
So it was NS's pick.
I don't think eXecutors will be happy, though. I think they want a lot more out of themselves.
I think CNN needs a play. And Anbu. Anbu, Cena, and Bratak. Anbu, Cena, and Bratak. Sorry, all these weird names. It's like a tongue twister. And don't turn that into a gay joke either, just because I said tongue twister.
No one said anything.
At the rate you guys are.
No one's thought anything. It's all on you.
No, but you found it.
It's all on you.
I would follow up on that, but I'm not going to.
Oh, Kepler. Been a little while since I've seen that map.
Oh, wow. Really? Interesting. Okay.
Well, I guess we'll be fighting in the two pillars room.
I mean, this might benefit them. It might help with dealing with Psy.
It's got a lot more space.
Space them out. Yeah.
That may be enough.
But they definitely have to use a different lineup for sure, though. They got to keep them on their toes if they want to pull this off. Because they're already used to the lineup from last round now at this point. So now they have to switch it up and throw in a curveball and make them readjust. Make Blue readjust. But if they throw the same lineup in, I feel like it would be a very detrimental thing to do. We'll see. But I think Andrew has gotten really good as of late. The last couple months, he's definitely stepped up his game.
Some people are not clever.
What?
Well, I'm just suddenly checking in the work emails and someone's like, this is great, thanks, Abdit. I currently can't lock my computer. Bloody, 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 blah. Because I know who should be on. I was thinking, like, it's two buttons on the keyboard. What do you mean you can't lock the computer?
It just came out of nowhere. Some people are not clever.
Oh, we're live. Shit.
Uh-huh.
Here we go, round two. Exciting. Don't mind the silly people. They're not here. Alright, I think eXecutors stand a bigger chance here, and I'm excited for it.
So Amber wasn't
playing. But it's still going to be uphill for them.
Doesn't look like he's playing. And they've kept on Cuba and Ista. Full singular lineup. They're playing on backstabs, that's for damn sure. But Vanessa being really aggressive. Oh, good hit onto our menu there. Oh. Maybe some TK action there. Good jump throw, though, by Tomo. They're doing a really good job at pissing off Psy. Lots of space to avoid him. And, good hit, though, before he died. He did a ton of damage to Tomo. Big hit onto a menu. Yeah, they're struggling a little bit. Oh, the TK came at a fucking terrible time. Am I here alone? Is anyone else here?
Yeah, I'm here.
I'm sorry. I'm texting.
Just a bit distracted, sorry. You're doing great. Keep it up.
Doing great, keep it up.
Almost low, Psy looks like he's going, and Psy's gone, 4-4.
I mean, it's 3 minutes in and tied at 4-4, that is much better, yeah.
They had a lead at one point, he's the first one on the pad. Oh, and that jump from MNU was disgusting.
MNU, the hope crusher.
Nah, his jumps are solid as fuck.
Yeah, they are.
This is a pretty solid team from eXecutors. Definitely, these three people have been playing together for a minute. So I think they could totally potentially pull this off.
But it is currently fighting quite well. On a good run.
Low and then the news low, I believe, but so is Ister.
I mean, all you need is just two frags and the game's even. I mean,
okay.
And a low Tomo in there perfectly. That was textbook.
He knew where he was the whole time. He was just aiming that up.
Yeah, Tomo thought he had lapsed in attention, but he had not.
He had not. Oh, lovely Bassine to finish off.
Dina!
Yeah, well done, Sine. That was a good run.
I told you.
It's still trucking with 13 hit points.
They're all low, though, is the unfortunate.
Never mind, MNU came along.
And that's where Manu's love for chaos comes in.
I took a slap to the face, though.
A little bit.
Ista kills MNU, which is good. Psy is low. Very low now.
This is a good round. Shit. Halfway through, and it's like 8-9.
Well, it's not quite halfway. 6 minutes is halfway. Oh! That's a good trade. No, it's a really good trade. He has much more HP than his teammate did. Oh, Psy nearly got in there.
Help him!
Oh, fuck. Psy is just so much of a fucking problem.
He knows how to get singles a hard time.
Yeah, really, really does, but MNU's playing really well.
Yeah. MNU's on form tonight, that's a big problem for eXecutors. There's Tomo with his trademark, 1-1. He's like a wall on legs, it just moves around.
I want a round three! I just love my round threes, I don't know why.
It's pretty close, you might get one.
I think so. Alright, now it's halfway. Are you feeling better now? How? Did you just yell in the background?
Not sure about that.
Oh. Yeah, he did.
Sorry, I was in the kitchen.
Yeah, I knew it. I told you. I was like, did he just yell in the background?
Two frags in it.
One.
Ty's struggling. 3-6. Looks like he's getting frustrated. Oh, 13-13.
Nice.
Yes. Let's go red. Give me a round three.
Because if you, Sai's doing really well there, but if you really want to make use of Sai, then the team needs to have better teamwork to make use of the pressure he provides.
That was a great run by Cuba, by the way.
Yeah,
Cuba's doing well. 6-5. Only positive on his team. There must have been TK.
Oh, there goes Sai again, though, crushing dreams with his staff. Which is so mean.
Cuba killed Tomo.
Oh, he caught Q-Bert there as well. Shredded him.
Would have kept going.
This shelf is not a good place for executives to fight.
No, but he's doing damage though.
No, they need to stand together.
That's gotten back up to 6-6. In fact, all of NS are equal. So
he's just gobbling up the singles at the moment. Catch them alone and just overwhelms them with staff. Oh, nice. That was fantastic, executives.
Yeah.
But the funny thing is, it was right after Istin nearly killed himself from fall damage.
Oh my god.
And there's the third TK.
Stop it. This is such a beautiful round. Oh my god, Sina, did you really just fucking do that? Oh my god. Oh my god, I have anxiety just watching this right now. Oh my god.
What a dirty place to fight. Oh,
right?
I've died for that
kick. Crap.
I should have known better. That was rude.
Oh my lord.
Well, I think it says about the
dog. Wow, he knows this map really well. Tina does. The way he's jumping around, he's using every ledge of a curved ledge to use it as a boost to go into like another area of the map. He knows this map really well.
Sai got too aggressive there. Paid for it. Executives like, plus two. Nice. Good comeback. In fact, fantastic comeback.
It's like, I'm not gonna say anything. I'm just gonna say, keep going, people. I still want my round three, so. Oh, he's low. Whoever that is. Tavion. Oh, maybe not. Guess not. Watch out! Shit.
Oh, executors have the lead.
Mm-hmm. They're doing really well.
Yeah, they're holding strong, actually, this round. They're not playing around.
Two frag leads.
It's very close. Very, very close.
Sorry about my camera work, everyone.
One frag lead.
1.5 minutes left. Almost low on HP as well. Eyes on low HP. Someone gets Cuba.
Even.
But in a way, that's not a bad situation. Sai and Tomo are very, very low.
Yeah, good luck chasing Tomo.
That may be true, but I think Sai will go down. Over a minute.
Oh, MNU went. Oh, was the... Clean. Yeah, he was.
100 HP. Now, and there's that Tomo.
Yeah.
Oh, there's a TK.
Oh my god. No way.
I was about to say nice kill by Tomo, but yeah.
Oh.
Oh.
They're pulling it off.
Wow. If
dream's real.
Okay. I swear to God, if Executors loses this after this.
Oh, I think
they
this
are
is
losing
wrong.
This. 3 minutes left, and Tomo's. No, he's not low.
Oh no, my God.
I think they're too experienced to throw this away cheaply.
What a match!
Oh, TK
oh,
came
no.
in. He got a frag.
TK's not
though.
What they needed right now.
Nah, but slowed down the enemy a lot. 10 seconds, free frag. Can't do that.
You but died for the cause.
Yeah, no, it's game. What a round! Wow.
GG.
Well done, Executors.
Damn. Nicely done.
Well, we said at the beginning, the Executors, you know, they've been practicing a lot. They're pulling out good performances without quite getting the wins. And, yeah, I think NS is there for the taking.
You got to find the right lineup, too. They have a lot of, you know, when you have, I mean, I feel like they're a pretty fair team where they have, like, six players and all of them participate in TDM. But, like, you're always going to have a certain couple or three that just have a natural chemistry. And unfortunately, if you know, I mean, if that's the best team, that's kind of the direction you gotta go with.
Do they have it in them to win the third round as well? That's the question.
Do you think Anbu's gonna play?
I wouldn't change the lineup. If they won with that lineup, they should keep. They should stay on it.
I think they have the ability to frustrate the enemy enough. If they can frustrate and get Sai angry, or Tomo frustrated, they can win.
You just crack that one person where they just start wanting to chase you nonstop, and then boom. But I mean, I would agree. I would probably use the same lineup, unless I mean, I also don't know. I don't play with their team, so. You know, maybe others have different vibes with others, and I don't know.
I guess we'll find out soon enough.
Yep, same lineup.
Don't fix what isn't broken.
Exactly.
Amen.
Amen, brother.
That kind of evening, isn't it?
I didn't believe it.
What's happening?
One of them's gone for a cigarette.
Oh.
But it's very easy to like eXecutors, though. They're bottom of the ladder. They've played the most games. They keep playing, and they just keep pushing more and more towards a win. And it's a good attitude to have. So it sounds like eXecutors are going to play too bad after this.
Ooh.
Really?
Yeah, Ambu's going to play, which is nice.
Oh, I remember smoking cigarettes. Oof, man. I smoked cigarettes for 14 years. A pack and a half to a full pack a day. 14 years straight.
I've never smoked cigarettes.
Me Don't neither. Ever start, dude. Me never neither. Start.
At least you managed to quit, though.
It is the worst. One of, like, it's such a terrible hat. Like, not even think, like, not even referring to, like, any of, like, oh, it smells or this or that there. This, like, and, like, the psychological, like, the nicotine, like, it is so addictive. Like, just don't ever start. Maybe a drunk cigarette here or there, or take a puff here or there, yeah. But, like, don't ever buy one pack of cigarettes, because at that moment, you're just going to get addicted at that point. Just don't do it. Ever. It's not worth it.
Don't smoke cigarettes, kids. Smoke marijuana instead.
The marijuana?
Yeah.
That's alright. It's okay. You're gonna pump our gas someday. See, it's from the same movie. Bring it on.
Can you do that? Have you memorized the dances by any chance?
A little bit.
Yeah, thought so. Fucking
I'm sexy. I'm cute. I'm popular. And I do.
Tech.
The boys I love to stare. I'm funny. I'm hot. I'm everything you're not.
Hey, one serious question, Tech. Are you drunk?
What?
Are you drunk?
No, I'm stoned. But
even better.
I'm also just getting a little bit more comfortable with you guys. So you're just kind of seeing me make fun of myself.
I mean, we do it to ourselves all the time. It's kind of one of the big differences between American... Well, not so much anymore, but at one point, the big difference between, like, British comedians and American comedians was that British comedians mock themselves more than anything else. The American comedians were mocking other people. We're a big country of mocking ourselves.
I feel like if you can't laugh at yourself, then I don't understand life. Like, I don't know. I think laughing at yourself shows kind of acceptance of your own faults in a way. Where, like, you kind of just make fun of yourself and laugh at it, and but like you're cognizant of whatever it is, you know, like let's just say, you know, some random comedian forgets to put the toilet seat down and his wife yells at him all the time. Oh yeah, sorry, game.
Never mind. I'm sorry to interrupt you. NS started really well there, very, very solid.
Stepping back in.
Pretty clean with their kills.
It seems like NS is pretty determined this round.
Yeah. Really.
The way that they started off, like, they were very... It seemed like they're very, like, all right, guys, you know what? Let's just do this. See if it stays consistent or not. I mean, it's still really close. It's only 2 frag difference. It just started, so... The way that, eXecutors performed last round was amazing, so it could go either way.
That was some friendly fire just now.
See? It's already tied. Oh, this is gonna be a good best of three.
Really nice performance here from MNU. Another great kill.
Back again.
He's in it to win it.
MNU's had a really good start. This day they fell asleep there.
I mean, honestly, Manu can be kind of annoying sometimes because like there are moments, even if it's a pug or not, like where he'll either just feel like he decides to want to try and then like he dies and then doesn't want to, and he's always so random. It's like I never know what level his brain is at, which works to his advantage. He's very in and out, and it kind of reverse psychologically thing messes with your brain. Because if you know somebody is completely on, you know to expect them, you know what they're going to come at you with. But, like, he's just so in and out, it's hard to, like, gauge it.
Now they've moved it to a different area. It seems to have slowed down a little bit, cooled off.
I think Executors needs to pull them into a tighter room. I think if they're giving them too much space, it might work towards Blue's advantage. Maybe? I'm not really sure.
The four frag lead though, it's quite solid. Just as low as well.
Yeah, NS are working hard for this one. Oh, another great kill.
Oh, TK there.
Weird left swing too.
It's low.
Oh.
Good kill there by I.
Sai.
Yeah, Sai, sorry.
And another one. Getting into it.
Ski.
Some real momentum here from NS.
We used to call him Neville. The joke. At one point.
Neville.
Yeah.
Isn't that from Harry Potter?
It's a British name.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. So Neville from Harry Potter. Totally.
Yeah, well, yeah. Gary Neville as well, the footballer.
Oh, yes. He just went on to sports. You already lost me, bro.
Do you know what Gary Neville's dad was called?
Daddy Neville.
No.
I don't know.
Neville.
He never, ever.
Neville. It's, pretty unfortunate.
Never, ever. Right, well, I think Blue has, I think No Surrender has kind of solidified the match. They've kind of taken control at this point now.
Yeah.
I mean, not going to say Red Executors can't come back from this. They totally have the ability to but I think at this point...
4 minutes left, it's a huge ask.
Oh, shit.
I don't think they've got that player that's like a big fragger, to be honest. Or someone that's going to really turn this around.
If they did, it would be one of the biggest comebacks.
Yeah, it would.
My biggest surprise this round is the amount of frags Atomo has. He's really going for it.
I mean, the number of frags in general is really, really low.
Yeah. But it's uncommon to see Tomo with like high frags on the team.
Aye.
It's not really what he does on the team. Maybe he's taking more risks, or they're running out of a bit more, who knows?
I think Cena should allow Cena to... I don't know, for some reason I remember Cena as a very aggro player back in the day when I was around.
No, I always saw him as someone that was very active in backstabbing, like very quick going around backstabbing and pissing everyone off. But he seems
maybe that's what I'm picking up on him.
It's the very to put Tomo very, down, very crush Cooper twice.
Yeah, he's always doing something. Which is good. I think if maybe he was given enough setups, he would be able to maximize on that back play. Maybe.
Yeah, but I don't think they haven't got enough players that set up through pressure and whatever.
Tomo pans Cupid again. Really big hits from Tomo. Tomo near the TK side there, but not quite. Good match overall, but this is a very strong round from NS.
It is, yeah. But I still think NS has got a bit of improvement to go before they beat one of the big four.
Hmm.
I would agree. But I have to say, like, I think all of the teams that are in the ladder, from what I've noticed, are pretty, like... It's a well-balanced ladder, honestly. Like, maybe it's just the age of the JKA. Everybody's, like...
Experience and just, open, you know.
Yeah. I don't... Well. Yeah, and I feel like, you know, if anybody at a certain time could take any win at some point, you know, because of the experience that is in this ladder of everybody that's playing...
I mean, I'd like to see Cerberus play against NS. That'd be an interesting game.
Who's in Cerberus now, though?
Maybe.
Kane, Mags.
Is it still Piccolo, Mags?
Kane.
Yeah. So that.
Yeah, it's me, Mags, and Pico is the lineup currently. Comma's currently not playing.
Oh, okay.
When's he back?
Not sure. Unknown at this stage. You may begin. I think we'll see Peruna back in Cerberus before then.
Yeah. Thank you, everyone, for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. It was a good game. Congratulations, eXecutors, on their round win. And congratulations, No Surrender, on their match win. Thank you, everyone, for watching. Yes, and thank you for all you commentators with me. Peace out.